Hey, it's Ross. It's time to talk permissions, specifically permissions around workdocs. Let's dive in. We'll start on the ground level with workdoc types. We have main workdocs, visible to anyone who is a team member within your account, private, which can be seen by the person who created it and the specific team members invited to join, and shareable, for collaborating with people outside your team. Okay, every doc type gives you the ability to invite account members, or guess if it's a shareable doc, from here. Inviting members is important because you can toggle ownership on the doc, which takes us to the next level of permissions, editing. By default, anyone with access to the doc can edit, but toggle this setting on and now only doc owners can edit the contents inside. This is how it looks when a non-owner goes to edit with that setting toggled on. Cool, right? Let's say I'm an ad agency and I want to share a pitch doc with a potential client. You can now share a doc with external parties by generating a public link from here. Docs with a blue banner at the top will signify a public-facing doc with an accessible link. And with this, to ensure the privacy and security of your account's data, embedded boards and widgets, attached files, comments, and uploaded videos will not be shown on the public-facing link. Fun fact, enterprise customers can actually toggle the public-facing link feature on or off for the entire account within the permissions tab of the admin section. You can adjust this for both members and admins in the account. If toggled off here, no one in the account, even if they're an account admin or workdoc owner, can generate public links for any workdocs in the account. Easy. And that's it for now. Take back control over what information can be changed and collaborated on with workdoc permissions. Click here for a full tutorial on Monday workdocs.